Leslie wishes she could be here herself to give you these presents, but she's suspended. Oh, and also she said that they're not from her, they're from Santa Claus.
Can I go first? Mouse rat, certified gold. Over 100 copies sold in Pawnee. I need to get a picture of me holding this so I can frame it.
Personalized leopard printed robe, pink feather cuffs, and on the back in rhinestones, you can get it.
I know you're sad you couldn't get tickets to the Watch the Throne tour, so I got you a watch and a tiny throne instead. And check it out, she even took out the dumb clock part and put this in. Baller time.
These are the black eyed peas. And I finally killed them. It's a Christmas miracle.
Every year, I give Leslie the same present I give everyone, a crisp $20 bill. And every year she gets me something thoughtful and personal. It makes me furious. This year, she outdid herself. She had it installed over the weekend. It's so beautiful.
I need to give you your Christmas gift now because, well, I'll just tell you.
What?
For the past few months, I've been sending Dwight letters from the CIA.
Are you serious?
They're considering him for a top secret mission. There's his application, and this is where I made him list every secret he promised he'd never, ever tell.
Last year, my boss, Michael Scott, took a day off because he said he had pneumonia, but really, he was leaving early to go to magic camp. Wow.
So here's the gift. You get to decide what his top secret mission is. Sorry I didn't wrap it.
Sorry, I forgot to tell you. I intercepted a transmission earlier, and it seems that the CIA is going to need Dwight down in their headquarters at Langley for training and an ice cream social with the other agents.
We should get him a bus ticket to make his trip easier.
Oh, no, that would be very good. Guy.
It costs $75.
Well, maybe the CIA could send a helicopter.
You have been compromised. Abort mission. Destroy phone. Destroy phone.
Kenneth, bag of names. Secret Santa. Secret Santa.
Kenneth is doing a Secret Santa fun swap thing.
He takes the two worst parts of Christmas, giving and rules, and combines them.
And then the person with the highest number gives the smallest gift to the tallest person. If they want to switch, they cannot. Unless they do, then everyone puts their head down except the murderer. Oh, wait, that's not right.
The whole thing was so confusing, I ended up getting my own crappy gift back. Like I need two copies of Over 60 Vixens.
A tree. We're not the paper towel guy.
Come on, Amy, it's Christmas. Plus, this will be the first legal thing I've ever done in the woods.
No, guys, what if one of us gets hurt? I have enough to worry about today. Dina.
Cheyenne, give her the axe. Now, just as an experiment, take one whack, all right? You don't have to go full fell. If you don't like it, tree farm it is.
Fine. One swing for Dina.
Now, you're not gonna wanna hit it straight on, okay? Angle it down like you're dealing cards to a baby.
Ooh. I mean, I guess I see the appeal.
Eat my axe!
No, Amy. Axe, Cheyenne, axe.
Oh, that's a weird thing to say. Who wants to eat an axe?
Timber!
No, you don't say that until...
Timber!
No, no, you wait and say it in a pause.
Timber!
Paul Bunyan can suck it!
Amy, I'm so sorry, but could you just step back like a teensy bit?
Oh, she's grabbing! Finish her, Sosa.
Let's do this!
Okay, so, to get it inside...
That's a solid question.
I have no idea.
Come here, come here. You gotta see this. I'm about to give Captain Holt his gift.
Oh, did he lift his no-gift policy?
No, he didn't. But I figured out a way to buy him something and trick him into accepting it.
You are bad.
I know, right? Oh, wait, you're making fun of me.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't care. He would never open a gift, right? But what if his gift didn't look like a gift?
He would open it?
Exactly. I left it in a cardboard box on his desk. There's no card, just the words, open now, which I wrote with my wrong hand so he wouldn't recognize my handwriting. Captain.
Santiago, Peralta.
Sir. So, just to recap, you left an unmarked package on a police captain's desk on a random Monday with a suspicious message written on it that looked like it was scrawled by a crazy person.
Mm-hmm.
Bomb! There's a bomb! Everyone out! Let's go! Let's go! This is not a drill! Let's go!
Great gift, babe.
Ready to take that tour?
Ugh, really? We're still gonna do this?
We're about to enter the fully preserved tenement of an Irish immigrant, the widow. Carolyn O'Sullivan. Welcome to Christmas, 1912.
Where is she? I think she's still asleep. I'm so hungry.
Where's Ma? It's Christmas morning and she's not out of bed yet. I think she was drinking again last night.
Ah. I had the nicest dream. I was rich and none of you was here.
Merry Christmas, Mother.
All right, me children. It's time for your Christmas presents. Gather close.
If we were any closer, we'd be our own aunts and uncles.
No one likes a funny girl, Mary. Now, do you want your Christmas onion or not? Then hold baby.
Why, doesn't baby have a name, Ma?
You know she'll get a name if she survives the winter. Don't want to get too attached. All right, children. Onions for all of you. Pour me a drink, Smitty. What if you run downstairs and give an onion to Old Man Flannery?
Old Man Flannery's gone. He was beaten to death with a pipe by an anti-Irish mob. They found his rotted body in the East River.
To say to cheer your mother up.
Yeah, I just got my replacement credit card. Do you want the number? Oh, it's 4793-0032-3313. The security code is 927. Okay, great. Thank you very much. Bye. So Dwight did take the bait. Use my credit card numbers to send a $200 bouquet of flowers to my wife. From me.
Boom! Rana's making the model, and then we're gonna put all of our candy decorations in our corners of the office. Okay, so what did everybody make?
Boom! Rock and roll, candy, Andy.
Wow.
Mm. That's really good, son. I didn't do anything for my office.
It's okay, I took care of it. I made a marshmallow Ron Swanson.
Oh my gosh.
His arms are crossed because he's mad at all the other marshmallow workers for annoying him. You like it?
It's fine.
So I made my desk out of silver M&Ms. Whoa. But they do not make silver M&Ms, so I spray painted them.
Okay, those are poisonous, so no one eat them.
Yeah, duh.
Go throw up.
I didn't eat any.
Go throw up.
What's going on here?
Merry Christmas, Leslie. We made you this replica of the Parks Department out of gingerbread.
Oh my God, I love it. Oh, I love it, and I love you guys, and Anne specifically, and all of you. You did all of this together?
Yes, except for me. Turns out I cannot make a gingerbread house, which would bother me if I were an 8-year-old girl.
You do realize we're going into quadruple overtime.
So what? We're giving America the perfect Christmas beat. There are some kids out there who never get that. I know I didn't. Not with Colleen around. My dad was long gone, so every Christmas, Colleen would bring her friend, Mr. Schwartz, over for dinner, and she'd make me play songs on the piano when she would sing to him.
My parents divorced when I was 9.
And every year, the dreadful moment arrived when I would catch Mr. Schwartz caressing my mother's bony thigh. And I'd say, "Eyes on the keys, Jackie boy, keep your eyes on the keys." And they'd ask me to play White Christmas, and it would turn into some boozy, burlesque travesty. Every time I hear that song, I get aroused. What is wrong with me?
I have to go to the prop meeting now.
How come you got Mrs. Claus?
I didn't realize you were serious about that, so I cut it.
You can't cut Mrs. Claus. Everyone knows that on Christmas Eve, Mrs. Claus hangs your stockings, then puts out food for Santa. Then you sing songs around the piano until she tucks you in. Did your mother not do that?
That's not a thing, Jack.
Yes, it is.
No, Mrs. Claus must have been something special that Colleen did, probably to make up for the fact that your dad wasn't around.
No. Christmas in the Donaghy house was awful. Have I not told you about my mom's Yuletide boyfriend, good old Frederick August Otto Schwartz III?
F.A.O. Schwartz, like the toy store?
His family owned some toy stores, yes. So what?
Jack, I think your mother put out on Christmas to get you kids presents. She did it for you.
Not possible. She didn't do anything for us.
I know you guys were pretty poor. Did you have a lot of presents?
You couldn't even see the tree.
Do you think we'll still be friends when I get sent back to the Philippines?
Of course we're still gonna be friends. Oh, maybe I could come visit you. I hear they have nice beaches and really cheap massages. I bet I could get a deal on a ticket if I book it far enough in advance.
Cheyenne, I'm about to be deported and you're planning your vacation.
Sorry. But the hotels are super inexpensive, right?
Oh my God, so affordable.
That's what I heard.
Yeah.
It's great. Mateo. Could we talk? Sure. So I ran your social security number.
Okay, look, I know it's...
And it checked out.
It did?
Yep, it did.
So that's that.
Merry Christmas, Mateo.
You've been legal this whole time? How much attention do you need?
And so concludes this year's Secret Santa drawing. Just a quick reminder of the rules. $40 limit, no perishable items, and no homemade massage coupons, Hitchcock.
Fine, then everyone will have to pay full price for them.
Oh, Captain, I would like a $40 gift card to any restaurant that serves nachos.
I don't have you, Peralta.
Not only do I know that you do indeed have me, but I also know who everyone else has.
That's not possible.
Perhaps not for ordinary men such as yourself, Jeffords, but for the brilliant mind of Detective Jacob Sherlock Peralta, I legally changed my name. It's quite simply elementary. For you see, Amy made a face I only recognize from our bedroom, which means that she has Captain Holt. Charles has Terry. His eyes keep shifting over to him.
No, they don't.
Terry looked disgusted, which means he has Hitchcock. Rosa didn't draw a name, nor did she put one in. She doesn't want to participate.
Never do.
Hitchcock moves his mouth when he reads, and he quite clearly said Charles.
I did get Charles.
Scully has Amy. He's holding his paper name side out.
Oh, he's good.
And I have Scully, which means Captain Holt has me. I'll be taking that gift card. Daddy loves nachos.
Should we draw the names again and leave Jake out?
Yeah! Yeah.
No! Sherlock, what's a present?
I'm sorry.
Okay, this is it.
What?
Go.
What? This is what?
Go, go.
Oh my God! Honey?
In the end, the greatest snowball isn't a snowball at all. It's fear. Merry Christmas.